A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today I am dealing with uniform plane waves. And this is my lecture 3 of Unit 5. Now, the outline is, the first concept is wave propagation in free space, and the second concept is wave propagation in dielectrics. So let us do the introduction first. That is, what are waves? So waves are nothing but that the means of transporting energy from source to destination. So the main job of these waves is to transport the energy or the information from one point to the another point, or else we will call it as source to destination. So if the waves are consisting of both electric field as well as magnetic field, we will call such waves as electromagnetic waves. So the electromagnetic waves are the waves which has the characteristics of both electric field as well as magnetic field, and they will transport the energy from one point to the another point. So these waves are always a function of a time as well as space. So we have done the concepts of electric field in electrostatics, magnetic field in magnetostatics, and now we are combining both of them, the characteristics of both electric and magnetic field, and we are constructing or we are deriving the equations for wave, that is general equations for wave. Now whenever the waves are propagating, then the medium is, it may be the free space or it may be any other medium, we will call it as dielectric, any other medium with having values of epsilon r or else mu r. That means the waves can be propagated either in a free space or in any other medium called as dielectric. So let us first study the concept of these waves in free space. So whenever if I say free space, then epsilon is equal to epsilon naught and mu is equal to mu naught. And we have done these conditions or characteristics in electric as well as magnetic field already. Now let us start with the first one, that is wave propagation in free space. So the uniform plane wave means both electric field as well as magnetic field vectors are in the same plane. So such a plane we will call it as uniform plane. And since the medium is a free space, we are deriving the equations for, that is wave equations in free space. Now let us have a look at the Maxwell's equation considering the free space concept. Since the medium is sourceless, the current density J is equal to 0, and we will list the Maxwell's equation as, first one is del cross H is equal to epsilon naught dou E by dou T, del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou H by dou T, del dot E is equal to 0, and del dot H is equal to 0. So these are the four Maxwell's equation which I have defined it as in free space. So the del cross E as well as del cross H we have already derived from Faraday's law as well as Ampere circuital law, and these two are the Gauss law in magnetic field as well as electric. So the del cross H is equal to epsilon naught times dou E by dou T, and del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou H by dou T. We will use it for further derivation. That is, let us assume that the electric field E is having only X component, that is Ex Ax, or that the electric field is polarized in the X direction, and we assume that it travels, or the wave travels in Z direction, then we will write the del cross E component as del cross E is equal to dou Ex by dou Z into Ay. So I am determining the cross product of E by assuming E is equal to Ex Ax and the wave is traveling in Z direction. Hence, we will write this as dou Ex by dou Z into Ay component. That means we have further assumed that the del cross E component will be there in Y component. Hence, dou Ex by dou Z is into Ay. So I will write this as for magnetic field. I will write this as, that is del cross E is minus mu naught into dou H by dou T. And I will write this as minus mu naught into dou H. I will write it as dou Y divided by dou T into Ay component. That means Ay component will survive. Now I have done the first equation with the Faraday's law, that is del cross E. Now let us see the second equation, that is Ampere circuit law, del cross H is equal to minus dou H Y Ax by dou Z, that is dou H Y by dou Z into Ax component is equal to epsilon naught times of dou E divided by dou T is equal to epsilon naught times of E. I have defined only in X direction. Hence I will write it as dou Ex by dou T into Ax component. So let us write the first equation, that is dou Ex by dou Z is equal to minus mu naught into dou H by dou T, and dou H Y by dou Z is equal to minus epsilon naught times of dou E divided by dou T, that is dou Ex component. So I have defined these two equations by assuming E is equal to Ex Ax, the wave is traveling in that direction, and Y component will sustain. Now, consider the first equation, that is the dou Ex by dou Z is equal to minus mu naught into dou H by dou T. Now, for this equation, differentiate both sides with respect to Z. So, whenever I differentiate with respect to Z, I will get dou by dou Z square, that is dou square by dou Z square into Ex is equal to minus mu naught into dou by dou T, and again dou by dou Z, that means dou square by dou T into dou Z, that is Hy component into minus mu naught. That is, I have defined the equation by differentiating the first equation with respect to Z. Now consider the second equation. Now second equation also, differentiate this equation with respect to T. So whenever I differentiate this equation with respect to T, the first term is dou square by dou Z dou T Hy component is equal to minus epsilon times of dou square Ex divided by dou T square. Hence, if I compare these two equations, I can write dou square E by dou Z square is equal to, now the term dou square Hy by dou T into dou Z can be replaced by minus epsilon times dou square Ex by dou T square. Hence minus with minus will become plus mu naught into epsilon naught dou square Ex divided by dou T square. So similarly for magnetic field, we will define it as dou square Hy by dou Z square is equal to mu naught into epsilon naught, that is dou square Hy divided by dou T square. Now we will define the term, that is 1 divided by square root of mu naught into epsilon naught. If you substitute the value of mu naught and epsilon naught in free space, we will get this as 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That is nothing but, this value is nothing but the velocity of light. So we will call this as velocity v, or else the constant c. So this equation can be written as in terms of v as well as in terms of c. So we can write this as 1 divided by v square. So these two equations we will call it as the equations for, that is, wave propagation in free space. Now if you see this, either you take ex component or hy component, the fields are varying with respect to time as well as space. So space here is that and time is t. So these two equations we will call it as the general equations, that is wave equations in case of free space. Now let us define the general form of forward and backward propagating waves. That is, since the wave is traveling in space and time, I will write it as ex of z comma t is equal to f1 of t minus z by v plus f2 of t plus z by v. So the f1 and f2 can be any function whose arguments is of the form t plus or minus z divided by v. So I have written t minus z by v, and here it is t plus z divided by v. Now from this ex of z comma t, I can define the forward as well as the backward term by writing in terms of cos omega t minus z divided by vp plus phi, where vp is nothing but the phase velocity. We will write it as c. Now we can write the forward as well as the backward equations in this form, and there is a constant k naught which is equal to omega by c radian per meter we will write, and from the constant k naught we can define the wavelength lambda is equal to 2 pi divided by k naught, that is in free space. Now we can write ex z comma t as only the real component of exs into e to the power j omega t. Hence we can define dou h y s by dou z is equal to minus j omega epsilon naught ex s of z. Or else now we can define the Maxwell's equation as del cross H is equal to j omega epsilon naught ES, del cross E is equal to minus j omega mu naught into HS, del dot ES equal to 0 and del dot HS is equal to 0. Now this is how we can define the Maxwell's equation in free space. And the del cross E, whatever we have, let us take a divergence on both sides for del cross E. So we can write del cross E as del of del dot ES minus del square ES, that is del square ES we can write it as del of del dot ES minus del cross ES, or else we can define del cross ES is equal to minus k naught square into ES, where k naught is the constant which we have defined it as omega divided by C. So from this we can define the value of hy, that is hy of z comma t also. So and E electric field E also, that is ex naught as well as ex naught dash, that is one is forward, another one is backward. So we can define the ex naught and ex naught dash in terms of mu naught as well as epsilon naught and h. And from this, the intrinsic impedance of a free space is defined by eta naught is equal to under root of mu naught divided by epsilon naught. And if you substitute the value of mu naught and epsilon naught, you will get the value as 377 ohms or else 125 ohms. This is the intrinsic impedance we will call it in case of free space. Now let us start our second concept, that is wave propagation in dielectric. Now it is very much similar to the wave propagation in case of free space, but only the medium is going to change. Instead of free space, it is dielectric. Hence, from the Helmholtz equation, that is del square Es is equal to minus k naught square into Es, we will call this equation as Helmholtz equation. And using this, we can define the value of k is equal to omega under root of mu into epsilon, because mu is equal to mu naught into mu r and epsilon is equal to epsilon into epsilon r. And using this, we can define the jk is equal to alpha plus j beta, where alpha we will call it as attenuation constant and beta we will call it as phase constant. And using this, we can define Ex is equal to Ex naught into e to the power minus az cos of omega t minus beta z. So from this, we can define the attenuation constant alpha as well as beta, as well as intrinsic impedance using this formula. And also, the magnetic field intensity associated with electric field intensity Ex also as Hy is equal to Ex naught divided by intrinsic impedance eta into cos of omega t minus beta z. Hence, we can define del cross Hs as Js plus j omega epsilon Es, that is del cross Hs is equal to Jas plus Jds, that is one J is because of conduction current density and one is because of displacement current density, which we have done already. And we will define Jk is equal to, or else k is equal to omega into under root of mu into epsilon dash into under root of 1 minus j into sigma divided by omega epsilon, where sigma is the conductivity of the medium. Now using this, we can define the value of alpha as sigma by root 2, sigma by 2 into under root of mu divided by epsilon, similarly beta, and we can define beta is equal to omega under root of mu into epsilon. And the intrinsic impedance eta can be defined as under root of mu divided by epsilon into 1 plus j sigma divided by 2 omega epsilon dash. So the concept of wave propagation in free space as well as wave propagation in case of dielectric can be understood by using or by solving number of examples. So let us start with example number one. That is, the equation for the uniform plane wave traveling in free space is given in phasor form, and the electric field is given by Ey is equal to 10.4 into e to the power j 2 pi into 10 to the power 90 minus beta x mu, that is micro volt per meter. And now we need to determine, find direction of propagation of uniform plane wave, first one. Second one is phase velocity v. Third one is phase constant beta. And fourth one is expression for the magnetic field in phasor form. So let us write first Ey is equal to 10.4 into e to the power j 2 pi into 10 to the power 90 minus beta x micro volt per meter. Now by looking at the above expression, it is clear that the electric field intensity has only y component, and hence we will write Ey is equal to em e to the power j omega t minus beta x volt per meter. And comparing this equation, standard equation, with the given electric field, we can write omega is equal to 2 pi into 10 to the power 9 radian per second, and em is equal to 10.4 into 10 to the power minus 6 volt per meter. So this is the first one. Now second one is, calculate the velocity, phase velocity, since the uniform plane wave is traveling in free space, we have already derived. It travels with a velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now third one is, I need to calculate the phase constant beta, that is beta is equal to omega under root of mu naught into epsilon naught. It is mu into epsilon other than free space. Since it is a free space, it is omega into under root of mu naught into epsilon naught. Hence, mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And if we solve this, we will get the value of beta as 20.958 radian per meter. We have calculated the constant beta. Now fourth one is, I need the magnetic field intensity. So we know that HM is equal to EM by E naught. But I need H. So EM is, we have already checked EM is equal to 10.4 into 10 to the power minus 6. And eta naught value, that is intrinsic impedance for free space, is 377 ohms. So from this we can calculate the value of magnetic field intensity as 0.0265 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere per meter. Now, as the wave propagates in x direction and electric field is in y direction, then the H has to be in that direction. Then only we will call it as electromagnetic waves. Hence, the value of H, we will write it as 0.0265 into 10 to the power minus 6, that is micro, into e to the power omega t minus beta z. So omega we know, that is 2 pi into 10 to the power minus t minus beta. Beta value we have calculated as 20.958 x into micro ampere per meter. Now let us solve the second example. A 300 megahertz uniform plane wave propagates through fresh water for which sigma equal to 0, mu r equal to 1 and epsilon r equal to 78. Then calculate attenuation constant, phase constant, wavelength and intrinsic impedance. So attenuation constant is 0. Looking at the problem, the wave propagates through a fresh water, hence directly we can write the value of alpha as 0. Attenuation is 0. Second one, phase constant. Now phase constant is beta is equal to omega times under root of mu into epsilon. And here mu is mu naught into mu r. And epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. And omega value is 2 pi f. F is 300 megahertz, 300 into 10 to the power 6. Mu r is 1, epsilon r is 78. Substitute the value, mu r is 1, epsilon r is 78, and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. So if you solve this, you will get beta value as, solve this and calculate the value of beta and you will get beta value as 55.529 radian per meter. Now third one is the wavelength, and wavelength we know lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta in meters. So 2 pi by beta, beta value is 55.529, substitute 55.529 and calculate the value of lambda in meters. So we'll get lambda is equal to 0.1131 meter. Then fourth one is intrinsic impedance, that is eta is equal to under root of mu divided by epsilon, that is mu naught into mu r by epsilon naught into epsilon r, and that is equal to mu naught 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is 1, epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is equal to 78, and solve for intrinsic impedance eta, and you will get this as 42.656 ohms. The intrinsic impedance, we will get it as 42.656 ohm. Now let us do the third example, simple example. A 9 gigahertz wave is propagating through a material that has a dielectric constant of 2.4 and loss tangent of 0.005. Now find alpha, beta and the wavelength. Now the loss tangent of dielectric is given by tan theta is equal to sigma divided by omega epsilon, and they have given loss tangent is equal to 0.005 is equal to sigma divided by omega into epsilon. So I can substitute the value of omega as 2 pi f, f is 9 gigahertz, and sigma is, or epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r, and epsilon r is 2.4 in the given question, and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. So if you solve this, first you will calculate the conductivity sigma. So the conductivity sigma is equal to 6 into 10 to the power minus 3. You will get answer. Now after finding the value of conductivity, now we can check which type of material is this. And sigma divided by j omega epsilon, if we substitute sigma as well as omega epsilon, we will get the value as very much lesser than 1, and hence it is considered to be practical dielectric. And we know the formula for alpha and beta for practical dielectric as alpha is equal to sigma by 2 under root of mu divided by epsilon, that is sigma by 2 under root of mu naught mu r by epsilon naught into epsilon r, that is alpha value, and beta value is omega under root mu into epsilon, and omega is 2 pi under root mu naught mu r epsilon naught epsilon r. Now in these two equations, substitute the value of epsilon r as well as mu r. Now if mu r is not given, let us take it as 1, and epsilon r is 2.4 into 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 in the equation of alpha. Similarly, in the equation of beta, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, epsilon r is 2.4, and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and calculate the value of constant beta. Now the wavelength lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta. So I need to calculate the value of alpha, beta and the wavelength. So I have done with the alpha and beta. Now lambda wavelength is equal to 2 pi by beta, that is 2 pi by 292. That is the beta value what I have calculated in radian per meter. And then we will get the value of wavelength lambda is equal to 0.0215 meters. Now the lambda value is 0.0215 meters. That is the wavelength. Now let us take the next example, fourth example. Calculate the attenuation constant alpha, wave velocity v, and the intrinsic impedance eta in sea water for uniform plane wave at 1 gigahertz. Now the constants for sea water are epsilon r is equal to 80 and mu r is equal to 1 and sigma is equal to 4. Now I need attenuation constant. Attenuation constant is alpha. Alpha is equal to sigma by 2 under root mu naught mu by epsilon, that is sigma by 2 under root of mu naught into mu r divided by epsilon naught into epsilon r, and substitute the value sigma as 4, mu r as 1, and epsilon r as 80. And we know mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, that is mu naught as well as epsilon naught. Now substitute all these values in the equation of attenuation constant and calculate the value of alpha. That is alpha value, we will get it as 84.24, which is the attenuation constant. Now second one is velocity. Now for a good dielectric, velocity V is equal to 1 divided by under root mu into epsilon into 1 minus sigma square by 8 omega square epsilon square, and 1 divided by under root of mu naught mu r epsilon naught epsilon r into 1 plus sigma square divided by 8 omega f. Omega is 2 pi f square, and epsilon square is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now in the question they have given frequency is 1 gigahertz, so f is equal to 10 to the power 9, we will take hertz, and we will substitute the value of mu naught as 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r as 1, epsilon naught as 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is 80, as well as sigma value is 2, sigma value is 4, hence 4 square. Now we will calculate the value of V by substituting all the values, and we will get it as 30.13 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second is the velocity. Now we will calculate the intrinsic impedance for a good dielectric is given by eta is equal to under root of mu by epsilon into 1 plus j into sigma by 2 omega epsilon, and substitute all the values as mu naught into mu r, and epsilon as epsilon naught into epsilon r. Also frequency value, that is 2 pi f, and the sigma value. Substitute all the values to calculate the intrinsic impedance, that is eta. And we will get it as 42.12 into 1 plus j 0.45 ohms. That is the intrinsic impedance. So this is how we will calculate the value of alpha, velocity v, and eta. Now let us take a fifth example. That is a 9375 megahertz uniform plane wave is propagating in polystyrene. The medium is polystyrene. Then, if the amplitude of the electric field intensity is 20 volt per meter and the material is assumed to be lossless, then find attenuation constant, phase constant, wavelength in polystyrene, velocity of propagation, intrinsic impedance, propagation constant, and amplitude of the magnetic field intensity. And for polystyrene, they have given the value for mu r is equal to 1 and epsilon r is equal to 2.56. So this is a very important question for the point of exam, because too many parameters you need to determine here. Now let us start with step by step. Now since they have given it's a lossless medium, then sigma is equal to 0. And if sigma is equal to 0, the attenuation constant alpha is also equal to 0. Second one, phase constant beta is equal to omega under root mu into epsilon. That is omega as it is. Mu into epsilon we will write it as mu naught mu r epsilon naught epsilon r, and substitute all the values, that omega as 2 pi f. F is 9375 megahertz, that is 9375 into 10 to the power 6. Mu naught 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Mu r is 1. Epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And epsilon r is equal to 2.56. It's given in the numerical. Substitute the values and calculate the phase constant beta. That is beta is equal to, you will get it as 314.37 radian per meter. You will get phase constant beta is equal to 314.37 radian per meter. Now third one, let us take wavelength in polystyrene is given by lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta. And beta we have calculated it as 314.37, hence 2 pi by 3, 2 pi divided by 314.37, and we will get the value of lambda wavelength as 0.01998 meters. That is the wavelength what we have determined. Now let us take fourth one. That is the velocity of propagation is given by v is equal to frequency into wavelength. Frequency, let us take angular frequency, that is 2 pi f, and into lambda. Lambda value we have already calculated as 0.01998 meters, and hence calculate the velocity. And velocity we will get it as 1.873 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now next one is the intrinsic impedance, that is eta is equal to under square root of mu by epsilon. Mu is mu naught mu r divided by epsilon naught epsilon r, and substitute all the values, that is mu r is equal to 1 and epsilon r is equal to 2.56, then we will get intrinsic impedance eta is equal to 235.45 ohms. 235.45 ohms. Next one is propagation constant gamma. We know that it is nothing but alpha plus j beta, and alpha value we have already determined as a 0. Hence, the propagation constant is only j beta, and beta value we have already calculated as 314.37. Now, the next one is amplitude of the magnetic field. Now, from the given question, the amplitude of electric field intensity is 20 volt per meter. Then we know that the intrinsic impedance eta is equal to E by H, that is EX by HY. And EX by HY. So EX value I know it as 20. then hy will become hy is equal to ex divided by eta. Ex is 20 and eta intrinsic impedance you have already determined as 235.45. Substitute 235.45, then we can find the value, that is amplitude of magnetic field intensity, as 0.08494 ampere per meter. Let us take one more simple example, that is a lossy dielectric is characterized by epsilon r is equal to 2.5, mu r is equal to 4, and sigma is equal to 10 to the power minus 3, and the frequency is 10 megahertz. Now find attenuation constant, phase constant, velocity of propagation, wavelength, and intrinsic impedance. Now for a lossy dielectric, first write the given data, that is mu r equal to 4, epsilon r is 2.5, sigma is 10 to the power minus 3, and the frequency f is 10 megahertz. And the first one, that is the propagation constant, is given by under root of j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon, and j omega, omega is 2 pi f, mu is mu naught into mu r, into sigma as it is plus j omega is 2 pi f plus into epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now substitute all the values in this equation, that is frequency f is 10 megahertz, 10 into 10 to the power 6, mu naught is 8, 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is 4, here also sigma value, conductivity is 10 to the power minus 3 plus j, omega is 2 pi f, f is 10 to the power 6, 10 into 10 to the power 6, epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is 2.5. Let us solve the equation. Solve this equation. And we will get it as alpha plus j beta is in the form of 0.2255 plus j 0.7. That is propagation constant. Alpha plus j beta is equal to 0.2255 plus j 0.7. Hence, from this, comparing with the standard formula, we can write alpha is equal to real part, that is 0.2255. And beta is equal to the imaginary part is 0.7 radian per meter. So this is how I have calculated the value of alpha beta. Now let us calculate the velocity of propagation, that is v is equal to omega by beta. Omega is 2 pi f divided by beta is equal to 2 pi f. F is 10 into 10 to the power 6 divided by beta you have calculated as 0.7. Substitute, calculate the value of velocity. So velocity we will get it as 8.9759 into 10 to the power 7 meter per second. Now we will calculate next one, that is wavelength lambda. Lambda equal to 2 pi by beta. 2 pi divided by beta is 0.7. Just now we have calculated, and substitute to calculate the value of wavelength lambda. Lambda is equal to 8.975 meters. Now the next one is the intrinsic impedance eta, and it is given by is equal to under root of j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon, that is j 2 pi f, omega value is 2 pi f, mu is mu naught into mu r, and epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now let us substitute all the values. 2 pi f, f is 10 into 10 to the power 6, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is 4, sigma is 10 to the power minus 3 plus j 2 pi f, f is 10 into 10 to the power 6, epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is 2.5. It is given in the numerical. So from this, you can calculate the value of intrinsic impedance eta. And we will get it as 429.39 at an angle of 17.86. The impedance, we will get it as 429.39 at an angle of 17.86 ohms. So this is how we will do the numerical. Let us take one more example, that is find a frequency after which the earth may be considered as a perfect dielectric, and assume sigma by omega epsilon is equal to 1 divided by 100, given sigma is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 3, mu r as a 10, and epsilon r is equal to 8. We need to calculate the frequency. So we will rearrange the given equation as 100 or else sigma divided by omega into epsilon naught into epsilon r. Is equal to 1 by 100 or else omega into epsilon naught epsilon r divided by sigma should be greater than or equal to 100. Omega value is 2 pi f, that should be greater than or equal to 100 into sigma divided by epsilon naught into epsilon r. So from this, f is equal to 100, sigma value 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by epsilon naught is 8.854. into 10 to the power minus 12, epsilon r is 8 into this 2 pi as it is. Now calculate the value of f, that is frequency, and we will get it as 1.1234 gigahertz. The frequency value we will get it as 1.1234 gigahertz. Now, based on this concept, that is uniform plane wave propagation in free space as well as in dielectric, along with the concept, we have done the example solutions. Now, based on this, let us answer quiz questions. That is, attenuation constant for the perfect dielectric is, first question is, attenuation constant for the perfect dielectric is it 0 or 1 or a minus 1? Yes, answer is option A, that is attenuation constant alpha is equal to 0 for the perfect dielectric. Now second one, phase shift constant is measured in, that is beta value, attenuation is alpha, phase shift is beta. It is measured in, phase shift constant is measured in, is it volt per meter or meter per second or radian per meter? Yes, answer is the option C, that is radian per meter, and attenuation constant value is 0. So these are the answers to the quiz questions, and this is what I wanted to cover today. Thank you all. Thank you very much.